Good morning, my name is Vishnu and today I am doing this video as part of my IEP course submission. So let me start about my topic. My topic is 15th Finance Commission. So what is the 15th Finance Commission? Let's talk in detail. So when people say that no other country carries within its diversity as India does, it's not just confined to the language, the religion, the customs. It's about the economy as well. For example, let's take the per capita income of Karnataka. It is 5 times that of Bihar, which is another Indian state. So expectedly, in this manner, if there are such vast inequalities in income distribution, then the union government has to take a stand how to distribute its share of taxes among the states. So for this, a technocratic committee called the Finance Commission was established under Article 280 of the Indian Constitution. So this technocratic commission traces its roots back to the British Raj in India, and almost it started around the 1930s. So this structure is needed for two purposes, because in India the taxes are collected by both the states and the union government as well. Some of the taxes like income tax and a part of the GST all go to the union government, whereas the state GST and other local excise, state excise, these kind of taxes go to the state. So once these taxes that go to the center, they need to be redistributed back. So this is a big challenge, because we have to ensure that this is taking place in a fair manner. So usually this Finance Commission, until 14th Finance Commission, the population was taken as a primary parameter on which these taxes are distributed. For example, they take the population of 1971, because in 1971 most of the states did not implement any kind of family planning procedures, so that all the states were on an equal threshold. So I'll tell you the revenues that come as from the central government. For example, in Bihar state budget, 68% come from the central proceeds, whereas for Gujarat only about 15% come from the central proceeds. The states like Madhya Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, Jharkhand, Odisha, they all get all close to between 40% and 50%, whereas the South Indian states like Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Andhra Pradesh and Telangana get something between 18% to 25%. So this kind of disparity exists when one state is getting close to 17%, another state is getting only close to 20%. There is bound to be some split among these states. So when we take population as an example, this ends up rewarding the North Indian states which are more populous, and ends up penalizing the states, South Indian states, which are much smaller but richer and who have implemented these population control measures in a more effective way. So these South Indian states feel that because they have implemented the population control measures in a more effective way, they are getting penalized. So what happened is, let me tell you about the penalizing. So till the 14th Finance Commission, the population of 1971 was the parameter. The 15th Finance Commission feels that the data is almost 50 years old. So the justification is not being done when you distribute funds, because the data is almost 50 years old. So it doesn't reflect the current scenario. For this, they have proposed that to take the population of 2011 into consideration. But if we take the population of 2011 into consideration, if we see the total fertility rate of the South Indian states is much lower than the North Indian states. When I say the total fertility rate, it means the number of children an average woman bears in her lifetime. So this is up at 1.5 to 1.6 in the South Indian states, whereas this is as high as 2.7 in some North Indian states. So to address these concerns, the Finance Commission has proposed that they will reduce the weightage given to population from 27.5% to 15%. And also, income distance is another parameter that they are taking into consideration. So, apart from this, but still, even after all these considerations, still the South Indian states are standing to lose a lot of their, a lot of the revenue that they used to get from central government, proceeds, not revenue. So Karnataka stands to be the biggest loser. It used to get 4.71%, but now it's getting just 3.65. The next four biggest losers are Kerala, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. Meanwhile, the Hindi belt saw an increase in its allocations, with Haryana and Uttar Pradesh receiving a larger portion of the pie. So the South Indians are alleging that the formula that they are using is faulty. They are saying that the inverse of the population fertility rate is being taken, but it's again being multiplied by 1971 population. It effectively, on the surface, it seems to reduce the focus on population, but it still ends up doing the same thing. It's again the population that is coming into picture. So, and they have also taken the tax efficiency. The tax efficiency is the efficiency of, like, for example, let's take tax efficiency also has population inside it, and the formula included, it's included in the formula. So in effect, we are not very sure how more population adds more efficiency to this formula. But as per this formula, it is reported that Bihar is scoring more than Tamil Nadu in the tax effort. So this does not seem to be reflecting the actual scenario. Hence, the South Indian states are vehemently objecting this formulas that are being used by the Finance Commission. And for this, the Finance Commission which was supposed to come into implementation this April, is still not yet finalized. So that was my topic, and thank you.